Good morning all. So in the today's class we will see about the three types of access controls. So we have seen the syntax of this inheritance. Like, what is the syntax for inheritance? First you have to write class keyword and what is the name of the derived class. So that's why I will write derived class name, and after this one derived class name I have to specify the what I have to specify. Yeah,
colon.
Okay, colon. And here you have to specify one special. And next to what is the base class? So this is your base class. So this is the syntax for defining a derived class. So first you have to write the derived class name, and we have to define the scope colon, single colon. It is not scope resolution operator, it is a single colon. And after this one you have to specify the access specifier, that is called access control. Okay, here you have to specify the access specifier, or which is also called as visibility modes. So there are three types of visibility modes or access specifier. What are those? Public, private, and next, protected. So these are the three types of access specifiers I will specify whenever I am inheriting. In case of .NET, you will be having some other keyword. Like in case of Java, we have extends keyword, which is used for inheritance. Okay. In case of Java, in case of .NET, have you seen about the inheritance concept in .NET? What is
yes, sir.
Yeah, what is the syntax for inheritance? Inheriting a class. Yeah. Anyone? Don't know.
Sir, we will just specify base class, and yeah. That and the class we are inheriting.
Yeah, just
same like that, sir.
Colon. Okay. In case of .NET also, you have to use the same syntax. But in case of Java, you will have class A, and next we have this class B. Extends an keyword use this one. Extends A in this manner. Arey, aday Python that is your class A undan konde. Then I will write like class B of A. Like this, I will mention. Okay, we have the same concept is there. Okay, in all the different languages, we have the same concept. Like. Whenever we are discussing about this object oriented programming languages, every language will have the same concept. Like it will have class, object, and inheritance, and data inheritance, polymorphism, data abstraction, data encapsulation, message passing, dynamic binding, everything will be same, but only the syntax will be different. The same thing, if you are in the C++, you have to mention class, derived class name, and colon. You have to specify the access specifier, and you have to specify the name of the base class. In case of .NET, you will write the base class, and after this one you will write class B, just colon A, no need to specify the access specifier. But in case of this Java, you have to write, you have to use the keyword called extends. Then I can say B is a class which is extending from A. So that is nothing but it is derived from this A. B is a class which is derived from A. And in case of this Python, you will write like B of A. So in brackets, you will mention A. So what is the meaning of this one? B is a class which is derived from A. So, but the concept is same. Inheritance, inheritance is nothing but deriving a class from one class, deriving a class from existing class, or process of creating a new class from existing class is called inheritance. So in the today's class, we will discuss about this three types of access controls. So in the question, they will ask, what are the different types of inheritance? I have two concepts based on the two categories. One is types of inheritance based on the visibility modes or access specifiers. Based on the visibility modes or access specifiers, this inheritance is divided into three types. Inheritance is divided into three types. That is public derivation, private derivation, protected derivation. But based on the normal inheritance, any types, and total six types. That is single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, hybrid inheritance, and the next one is your multipath inheritance. Total six types of inheritance are there. But in this question, they mention like, what are the different types of access controls in inheritance? What are the different types of inheritance based on the access controls? What are the different types of inheritance based on the visibility modes? There are three types of inheritance based on the visibility modes or access controls. That is public inheritance and private inheritance and protected inheritance. This is also called as public derivation, private derivation, and protected derivation. So we will see in detail. 1 minute. So inheritance, we have seen about this one. Inheritance is the process of deriving a new class from the existing class. Inheritance is the process of creating an ochu, deriving an ochu, edanochu. Inheritance is the process of deriving a new class from the existing class or creating a new class from existing class. Or inheritance is the process of inheriting the properties from one class to another class. In derived inheritance class, the control over the members of the base class depends on the type of the derivation. Ikkada deeni base iskoni manaki three types of inheritance definition. Like we have class A, this is the base class. Inside this base class, I can have three types of members. That is private may data members undochu, member functions undochu. Next public data members, member functions undochu. Next protected data members, member functions undochu. These three. And whenever I specify this class B, and here I will define this. I can derive this base class privately, or I can derive this base class publicly, or I can derive the base class protectedly. So based on this type of derivation or type of this visibility mode, I can, what is the meaning of that one means, I can act, I can control the access of these base class variables. Ante base class lo unnatuvanti a variables nenu access ade derived class ki nenu access ivvali anedi that will be decided by using this access controls. Got it? All of you got it right? So the main purpose of this one, access specifier enduku specify chestarante, private ani chepte naaku private variables vastaya, public variables vastaya, protected variables vastaya, vetini access cheyachu edi base class nunchi. Ade public ani chepte which are the variables that I can access from the base class. And protected ani chepte what are the different data members that I can access in the derived class. Got it? That restriction or access can be given by using a special operator, a special access specifier called visibility mode or access specifier. Got it? All of you got it right? Hello? Yeah, response ivvandi faster. Right. So in derived inheritance class, the control over the data members of the base class. This base class lo unnatundi a members ni control cheyadam ante ivi avi ravali na derived class can access those which variables anedi that will be depending upon the type of the derivation. That may be access specifier or visibility mode. So there are three types of derivations based on the access specifiers. One is public derivation or private derivation or protected derivation. Ikkada in private use chesthe then I can say it is a privately derived, okay? Then base class is privately derived into the base derived class. Base class is privately derived anachu. Public ana keyword use chesthe base class is publicly derived, and protected ana use chesthe base class anedi protectedly derived. So based on that one, I can have three types of derivation: public derivation, private derivation, and protected derivation. In case of this public derivation, this is the most important access specifier. In the public derivation, so whatever the, in three types of derivation, you have to remember one point, like private members of the base class cannot be inherited into the derived class. Got it? A type of derivation aina, that may be public derivation aina, protected derivation aina, lekapothe private derivation aina, whatever the private data members that are there in the base class, those cannot be inherited into the derived class. Only nenu access cheyagaligina ee enti anante base class lo unnatundi public gaane protected variables maatrame naaku derived class lo kostayi. Adi a type of derivation aina, private derivation aina, public derivation aina, protected derivation aina, any type of derivation I can control the, what is the main purpose of this one, types of modes of inheritance based on the access specifier is nothing but which is used to control the access of the data members that are there in the base class, which of the data members I can give the control to the derived class anedi decided by using this three types of derivation, that may be public, private, or protected. In all the three types of derivations, whatever the private data members that are there in the base class lokala evaithe private data undo adi matram naaku ఎప్పుడు యాక్సెస్ చేయలేను బికాస్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ కెనాట్ బి యాక్సెస్డ్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ద క్లాస్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏ క్లాస్ కెనాట్ బి యాక్సెస్డ్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ద క్లాస్ కాబట్టి నేను ఏ టైప్ ఆఫ్ డెరివేషన్ అయినా ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్ అయినా పబ్లిక్ డెరివేషన్ అయినా ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డెరివేషన్ లో అయినా ఈ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో బేస్ క్లాస్ లోవి అవి మాత్రం డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ లోకి యాక్సెస్ చేయలేను ఆర్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ లోకి రావు ఓన్లీ వచ్చే ఏంటికి పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ మాత్రమే వస్తాయి దట్ పాయింట్ ఇస్ క్లియర్ రైట్
Yes, sir.
Right. So each of the, so in case of this public derivation chesthe em avutundante whoever is having public section aa public lo unna ikkada public section lo kostayi ante, and protected lo evaithe unnayo avi ikkada protected section lo kostayi. That's it. This is your public derivation. in case of this public derivation, whatever the public data members that are there in the base class, that will become public members of the derived class. Public section lo evaithe unnayo avi be derived class lo public section lo kostayi, and protected members evaithe unnayo base class lo avi protected members derived class lo ki protected members aithe, ante public lo unnai public lo public members of the derived class aithe, protected lo unnai protected members of the derived class aithe. Each private members of the base class are not inherited to the derived class, hence it is visible only to the base class. Antigane private data members cannot be accessed outside the class kabatti these are not inherited into the derived class. So base class private members are never accessible directly from the derived class, but can be accessed through the calls to the public and protected members of the base class. That's it. Okay, so if you are taking a example like we have this class student, inside this class student I have this private data, that is registration number or hall ticket number, and name is there, branch is there, and semester is there. These are the private data members, and protected members same levu, and public members anevi rendu unnai except undi next display data. These are the two data, these are the data members and these are the member functions. Ippudu class student result anedi oka derived class, I am deriving by using from this student. Student is the base class. So ikkada man din ardham entante, already I have a student anedi okati class undi, within the student class I have this student class, within the student class I have this private data. What is the private data? That I have registration number undi, next name undi, next branch undi, next semester undi. These are the four data that I have in the private section. And in the public protected section la em ledhu, public section lo matram naku two data members unnai. One is your accept ane oka data member undi, next member function undi, next display data anedi oka member function undi. Dan tarvata from this student class I am deriving one more class called what? What is that class? Yeah, this is your student class. From this student I am deriving student result.
Student result.
Yeah, so student result anedi ela access chestunnanu, public public ga access chestunnanu, that is nothing but public derivation. So in all the cases, okay, in case of then I can say it is a public derivation. This is a public derivation because I am using this accessible mode as public, so that's why I can say it is a public type of derivation. In all the three types of derivations I cannot access this private data. So ee private data anedi ikkadiki raadu, idi raadu private data. Only vachedi enti di public data gaani protected data gaani. Protected anevi em levu kaabatti only public unnai dentloki ostayi, ikkada public section loki ostayi, ikkada public section loki ostayi. Ikkada already public lo display result anedi undi, so display result anedi already undi. Dintho paatu manaki ee accept tarvata display data anedi untadi. Private anedi by default ee class ki oka private data undi, that is called marks. Got it? All of you got it, right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
In case of this public derivation, only thing you have to remember: in case of public derivation or private derivation or protected derivation, whatever the private data that is there in the base class, this is called base class. From this base class, private data is not inherited. Only thing that I can inherit is either public data or protected data. And in case of this public derivation, public lo unnai, derived class public lo kostayi. Protected lo unnai, derived class protected lo kostayi. Got it? That's it. Okay, so ikkada naaku student base class undi, base class lo private data anedi four data members unnai, public lo rendu unnai. Student result anedi derived class, ee derived class private marks anedi undi, public loki already deentlo em undi okati display result anedi undi. Display result tho paatu ee display result anedi it is already defined inside the derived class, but this accept to display data anedi ekkada nunchi vachinayi, that is coming from this base class ikkada nunchi vachinayi. Okay, that is nothing but in case of this public derivation, private members of the base class remains private to the base class, hence it is visible only to the base class, not inherited. So private anevi evaithe private unnayo evi inherit kavu, public lo unnai public section lo kostayi. Okka vela ikkada protected lo evaina variables unte protected section lo kostayi, ante. Got it? That's it. That is about public derivation. And in case of this private derivation, and the second type of derivation is private derivation, if the visibility of the base class is private, then each public member in the base class is private in the derived class and protected. So that is nothing but, so whenever we have this in case of this private derivation, that is nothing but class derived class, and I am deriving base class is B, I am deriving, whenever this D is a class which is derived class, if it is specifying the access specifier as private, then I can say this D is a derived class which is privately derived from this base class B. So అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుందంటే బే అనేది బి అనేది బేస్ క్లాస్ అండ్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ క్లాస్ వి ఆర్ డిరైవింగ్ దిస్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అప్పుడు ఏ త్రీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ డెరివేషన్ లో ప్రైవేట్ డేటా అనేది యాక్సెస్ చేయాలి సో బి లో నాకు ప్రైవేట్ ఉండొచ్చు అండ్ పబ్లిక్ ఉండొచ్చు నెక్స్ట్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఉండొచ్చు ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఉండొచ్చు ఈ ప్రైవేట్ అనేది యాక్సెస్ చేయలేము ఏదైతే పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఉన్నాయో అవి ఈ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ లో ఏమైతాయి అంటే ప్రైవేట్ మెంబర్స్ అవుతాయి బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్ గాట్ ఇట్ అలా యు గాట్ ఇట్ రైట్ యా సో ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టూడెంట్ ఐ హావ్ దిస్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా ఉంది ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఏం లేదు ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో కూడా ఉంది ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో ఉంది నెక్స్ట్ పబ్లిక్ లో ఉంది సో ఇప్పుడు నేను ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్ అంటే ఏంటిది జస్ట్ ఐఎమ్ స్పెసిఫైన్ ద క్లాస్ అండ్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ స్పెసిఫైన్ ద యాక్సెస్ స్పెసిఫైర్ ఆస్ ప్రైవేట్ అండ్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ సో దిస్ వన్ సో ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ డిఫైనింగ్ దిస్ ఎంటైర్ థింగ్ ఇన్ ద డయాగ్రామ్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఫార్మ్ లో రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తే దెన్ what is this one we have this student so it is student class this is your student class ee student ane class lo private section undi private section lo naak em em unnai private within the private section we have this four data that is registration number undi name undi next branch undi next semester undi semester okay and in case of this protected protected lo aithenemo in case of this protected I have one method what is this one one function rank ane function undi rank ane function undi and in case of this public public lo aithenemo I have two member functions what are those accept ane function undi next display data so this is three things okay we have private data undi protected data undi public section lo undi this is your student class and next what is the derived class what is the derived class from this one I am deriving a new class called student result and student result anedi ela derive avutundi private ga derive avutundi so private ga derive ainaapudu in case of private derivation or public derivation or protected derivation private data cannot be inherited only protected public matrame inherit avutayi avi rendu em aitay ante ikkada ivi rendu em aitay ante it will come into the private section so in the derived class in the private section already marks anedi undi ee marks ane dantho paatu I have this rank ane function vachindi tarvata accept ane function vachindi next display result ane function vachindi okay so in case of this private derivation whatever the protected and public members that are there in the base class that will be become as private members in the derived class got it I have got it right
yes sir
yeah so in case of this private derivation whatever the protected and public evaithe unnayo avi rendu kuda dentloki vastayi pa private section loki vastayi so private section loki rank vachindi next accept vachindi display data vachindi and it has own private data marks anedi undi already naaku derived class lo it has its own private data marks and public section as it is undi so only thing that you have to remember is in case of private derivation or public in case of public derivation public derivation aithe protected private members are cannot be inherited and protected unnai protected loki vastayi public lo unnai public loki vastayi but in case of this private derivation protected public rendu kuda dentloki vastayi private section loki vastayi ante next can anyone guess what is protected derivation in case of protected derivation em avochu cheppandi anyone can guess yeah
rank
maybe data
yeah
protected loki vastayi sir
very good right యా ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డెరివేషన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ ప్రైవేట్ లో ఎలా అయితే పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ రెండు కూడా ప్రైవేట్ వేరియబుల్స్ ప్రైవేట్ సెక్షన్ లోకి ఎలాగైతే వస్తున్నాయో ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పబ్లిక్ అండ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ రెండు కూడా దేంట్లోకి వస్తే ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ సెక్షన్ లోకి వస్తాయి అంతే సో ద విజిబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ ఈస్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ దెన్ ప్రైవేట్ మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ రిమైన్స్ ప్రైవేట్ ఇన్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ ప్రైవేట్ ఎప్పుడైనా కానీ నేను యాక్సెస్ చేయలేను ఎందుకంటే యు హౌ ద ఫండమెంటల్ రూల్ ఆఫ్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ ఈస్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ కెనాట్ బి ఇన్హెరిటెడ్ ఇన్ టు ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అది మీకు ఆల్రెడీ తెలుసు ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ కెనాట్ బి ఇన్హెరిటెడ్ ఇన్ టు ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అనే కాదు ప్రైవేట్ మెంబర్స్ కెనాట్ బి యాక్సెస్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ద క్లాస్ అందుకని ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ అనేది యాక్సెస్ చేయలేదు హెన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ విజిబుల్ ఓన్లీ టు ద బేస్ క్లాస్ మాత్రమే విజిబుల్ అవుతుంది నాట్ ఇన్హెరిటెడ్ బై ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ విల్ బికమ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అండ్ పబ్లిక్ మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ విల్ బికమ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ దట్స్ ఇట్ ఓకే సో ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వన్ వెన్ ఎవర్ వీ హావ్ దిస్ స్టూడెంట్ దిస్ ఈస్ యువర్ స్టూడెంట్ క్లాస్ ఇన్ సైడ్ దిస్ స్టూడెంట్ క్లాస్ ఇన్ ద ప్రైవేట్ సెక్షన్ in the private section I have this registration number name undi next branch undi semester undi semester ee four unnai four data is there నెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ వన్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో ర్యాంక్ అనేది ఉంది, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో ర్యాంక్ ఉంది. నెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ వన్ ఇన్ ద పబ్లిక్ సెక్షన్, ఇన్ ద పబ్లిక్ సెక్షన్ ఐ హావ్ బోత్ యాక్సెప్ట్ అనే ఫంక్షన్ ఉంది, యాక్సెప్ట్ అనే ఫంక్షన్. నెక్స్ట్ డిస్ప్లే డేటా అనే ఫంక్షన్, రెండు ఉన్నాయి, టూ ఫంక్షన్స్ ఉన్నాయి. సో ఎప్పుడైతే నేను దిస్ ఈజ్ యువర్ బేస్ క్లాస్ స్టూడెంట్ అండ్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ క్లాస్ ఐఎమ్ డిరైవింగ్ వన్ మోర్ క్లాస్ కాల్డ్ స్టూడెంట్ రిజల్ట్. ఓకే, ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ స్టూడెంట్ రిజల్ట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ వన్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా. సో ప్రైవేట్ డేటా ఏముంది, మార్క్స్ అనేది ఉంది. అండ్ పబ్లిక్ అనేది ఏముంది, పబ్లిక్ అనేది దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ డిస్ప్లే రిజల్ట్ ఉంది. ఇక్కడ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లేదు, కానీ ఏమవుతుందంటే ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డెరివేషన్ ఐ విల్ స్పెసిఫై ద యాక్సెస్ స్పెసిఫైయర్ యాజ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ యువర్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అండ్ ఐ విల్ స్పెసిఫై ద యాక్సెస్ స్పెసిఫైయర్ యాజ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ అండ్ స్టూడెంట్. దెన్ ఐ కెన్ సే దిస్ స్టూడెంట్ రిజల్ట్ ఈస్ ఎ క్లాస్ విచ్ ఈస్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ స్టూడెంట్ క్లాస్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్లీ. అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుందంటే ప్రైవేట్ డేటా ఎలాగో ఇన్హెరిట్ కాలేదు, ఓన్లీ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ తర్వాత పబ్లిక్ రెండు కూడా ఇక్కడ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ సెక్షన్లోకి వస్తాయి. కొత్తగా ఒక ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ అనే సెక్షన్ క్రియేట్ అయ్యి దాంట్లో ర్యాంక్ యాక్సెప్ట్ డిస్ప్లే డేటా ఉంటాయి. దట్ ఈస్ యువర్ థింగ్. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఈజ్ యువర్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డేటా, పబ్లిక్ డేటా. దెన్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రైవేట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ డేటా మార్క్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఇట్ పబ్లిక్ డేటా దట్ ఈస్ డిస్ప్లే రిజల్ట్. బట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మెన్షన్డ్ యాజ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ బోత్ దిస్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ పబ్లిక్ అండ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ విల్ కమ్ ఇన్ టు ద పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ సెక్షన్. దట్స్ ఇట్. ఓకే, అలా యూ గాట్ ఇట్ రైట్? Have you, all of you following, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. So that entire thing I can specify in the table, then you can easily understand. So table of derivation and access specifier, we have three types of derivation types, that is private derivation and public derivation and protected derivation. If the base class is derived privately by using the private keyword, then I can say that is private derivation. If the base class is, derived class. If the derived class is derived from the base class publicly, then I can say it is a public derivation. If the base derived class is derived from the base class protectedly, then I can say it is a protected derivation. If the derived class is derived from the base class privately, then I can say it is a private derivation. In case of this private derivation or public derivation or protected derivation, I can have base class law, I can have private, public, protected data. I can have all these three types of data. In case of all these three types of derivation, whatever the private data members that are there in the base class cannot be inherited. అందుకని మనము ఇక్కడ మనం డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ లోకి ఇన్యాక్సెసిబుల్ అనొచ్చు, లేకపోతే కెనాట్ బి ఇన్హెరిటెడ్. యూ కెన్ సే హియర్ కెనాట్ బి ఇన్హెరిటెడ్. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్, పబ్లిక్ డెరివేషన్, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డెరివేషన్ లో అయినా, వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ప్రైవేట్ డేటా దట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ కెనాట్ బి ఇన్హెరిటెడ్ ఇన్ టు ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్. ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్, పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ రెండు కూడా ఏమవుతాయి, ప్రైవేట్ డేటా అవుతాయి. ఏది పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్, పబ్లిక్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ అయినా, పబ్లిక్ మెంబర్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అయినా, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ అయినా, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ మెంబర్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అయినా, విల్ బికమ్ యాజ్ ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ అండ్ మెంబర్ ఫంక్షన్స్ ఇన్ ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్. అండ్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ పబ్లిక్ డెరివేషన్, పబ్లిక్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ విల్ కమ్ ఇన్ టు ద పబ్లిక్ సెక్షన్ ఇన్ ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్. ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో ఉన్నాయి, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ సెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ లోకి వస్తాయి. ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డెరివేషన్, పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ రెండు కూడా ఏమవుతాయి, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ మెంబర్స్ అవుతాయి. ఓకే, టేబుల్ ద్వారా మీకు అర్థమైందా క్లియర్ గా? Right. So you have to remember this. These are the three types of derivations based on the accessibility modes or visibility modes or access specifiers. Okay, I can say access specifiers or access controls and also like the visibility modes and also based on this visibility modes or access controls or access specifiers. This inheritance is divided into three types. That is public derivation, private derivation, and protected derivation. In case of this private derivation or public derivation or protected derivation, whatever the data members that are there in the base class, private data members, those cannot be inherited into the derived class. Only derived class can access either public data members or protected. In case of private derivation, both public and protected data members of the base class will become private data members in the derived class. In case of this public type of derivation, public data members of the base class will become public data members in the derived class. Protected members will become protected data members in the derived class. In case of this protected type of derivation, both public and protected will become protected data members in the derived class. That is very simple. And you can define the same table in this type also. That is base class members access specifier. This is public derivation undi, private derivation undi, protected derivation undi. In case of base class low on 20 access specifier, base class low on 20 members anedi, private members anedi, protected members, public members. These are the three types of. అదే ప్రైవేట్ ఉంటే మాత్రం పబ్లిక్ డెరివేషన్ అయినా, ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ డెరివేషన్ అయినా, నెక్స్ట్ ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్ అయినా, ప్రైవేట్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద బేస్ క్లాస్ కెనాట్ బి ఇన్హెరిటెడ్. అదే ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఉంటేనేమో ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఒకవేళ పబ్లిక్ డెరివేషన్ లో ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ అవుతుంది నెక్స్ట్ యా ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పబ్లిక్ డెరివేషన్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ విల్ బికమ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద డెరివేటివ్ క్లాస్ పబ్లిక్ విల్ బికమ్ పబ్లిక్ ఇన్ ద డెరివేటివ్ క్లాస్ అండ్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ డెరివేషన్ ఇస్ ప్రైవేట్ డెరివేషన్ both protected and public will become private data members in the derived class in case of this protected derivation both protected and public will become protected data members in the derived class is that clear all of you clear right
sir
yeah we can see some of the example programs on this one yeah before going to these example programs I will discuss one more concept later we will go to this examples yeah we will see the different types of inheritance and after this one we will go to the example programs and public derivation and private derivation and protected derivation so that till now we have discussed about the types of inheritance based on the access specifiers or visibility modes in the same manner I have this types of inheritance what is the different types of inheritance and explain them with the examples okay so there are basically six types of inheritance in C++ in case of visibility modes access controls access specifiers aithe three types unnai that is public derivation protected derivation and private derivation but general ga inheritance anedi any types annapudu six types of inheritance will be there the classification of inheritance is based on how the properties of the base class are inherited by the derived class ante any classes anevi derive chestunnam anedi base chesukoni this inheritance is categorized into six types there are total six types of inheritance the first one is single inheritance multiple inheritance multi-level inheritance hierarchical inheritance hybrid inheritance and multipath inheritance the same concept have you got in the .NET also yeah
yes sir
right.
So the same thing again I am repeating so in case of this single inheritance okay what is single inheritance this is also called as simple inheritance in that exam you may get the question like explain about simple inheritance and kuda adugutaru this is also called as simple inheritance or single inheritance in case of single inheritance a class is derived from only one base class a class is derived from only one base class always the direction should be arrow should be in this manner because I can say derived class is deriving from this base class if the class is derived from only one base class then I can say it is a single inheritance in other words when a subclass inherits only from one base class it is known as single inheritance or simple inheritance so simple inheritance syntax enti class base and this is the body of the base class and class derived you have to specify the access specifier and base that's it okay this is single inheritance or simple inheritance got it if a class is derived from only one base class then I can say it is a simple inheritance or single inheritance okay I can say like this is your class A and I can say this class B and I can specify access specifier any access specifier that may be publicly or privately or protected internally I can have any type of derivation okay so here I can specify that it is public or private or protected okay so this is your single inheritance or simple inheritance what is single inheritance if a class is derived from only one base class then I can say it is a single inheritance and what is multiple inheritance this type of inheritance happens when the child class inherits its properties from more than one base class okay if the class is derived from two or more base classes then I can say it is a multiple inheritance if the class is derived from two or more minimum two undali that is nothing but we have class A and we have another class B and I can say we are deriving a class from two or more base classes here we have only two base classes C is a class which is derived from two base classes then I can say it is what type of inheritance multiple inheritance in this manner I can have any types of classes okay if a class is what is the definition for multiple inheritance is if a class is derived from two or more base classes two or more two anedi minimum endukante okate aithe nemo that is called single inheritance but if a class is derived from two or more base classes then I can say it is a multiple inheritance so here we have this class B1 and we have another class B2 and in this manner I have bn classes and I am deriving a class so what is the syntax for this one class base1 and we have another class base2 and I am deriving a class by using this access specifier base1 comma I will use okay how can I write this multiple inheritance is nothing but I will write class C and it is derived from both A and B so that's why I will specify public A comma private B. All of you got it? All of you following, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So yes, sir. This is called multiple inheritance. Okay. Whenever I want to specify multiple inheritance, those multiple classes I will separate with commas. So this is your class C, and ikkada varike chuste that is your single inheritance or simple inheritance. But if I want to derive from two or more classes, then I can say public A comma private B. I can specify anything. It should not. ఇక్కడ పబ్లిక్ ఉంటే ఇక్కడ పబ్లిక్ ఉండాలని ఏం లేదు. ఓకే, పబ్లిక్ ఐ కెన్ యూస్ పబ్లిక్ ప్రైవేట్. ఐ కెన్ సే దిస్ ఈస్ క్లాస్ ఏ విచ్ ఈస్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ పబ్లిక్ అలీ, సో దట్ ఏ అనే క్లాస్ లో ఉన్నటువంటి పబ్లిక్ డేటా మెంబర్స్ విల్ కమ్ ఇన్ టు ద పబ్లిక్ సెక్షన్. ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ లో ఉన్నాయి కాబట్టి ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ సెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సి లోకి వస్తాయి. నెక్స్ట్ బి అనే ప్రైవేట్ గా డిరైవ్ అయింది కాబట్టి బి లో ఉన్నటువంటి పబ్లిక్ ప్రైవేట్ పబ్లిక్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ రెండు కూడా ప్రైవేట్ మెంబర్స్ అవుతాయి ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ క్లాస్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ అనదర్ క్లాస్ డి అనేది ఉంది అనుకోండి, if I am D, then I can say like public, I can say public or protected anything D. All of you got it right? Following, right? This is very important concept.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So if a class is derived from two or more base classes, then I can say it is a multiple inheritance. Yeah. We have this class B1, class B2, and class D, which is deriving from publicly from B1 and protectedly from B2. So what is the syntax? Class D, and visibility mode I have to specify, that is public or private or protected, and B1 comma I have to use this comma, and visibility mode at B2 comma. Like this I can use any number of classes. So if I are taking this employee is a class which is derived from both person class and class qualification class. That's it. Multi level. So what is the meaning of level? That is level by level. So this type of inheritance is the best way to represent the transitive nature of the inheritance. So transitive nature, that is nothing but if a class is derived from one class and another class is derived from this derived class and another class is derived from this derived class, then I can say it is called level. So this is the first level, and this is called second level, and this is called third level. Okay, this is first level, this is the first level inheritance in which a class is derived from only one class. This is second level inheritance in which a class is derived from another derived class, and this is third level inheritance in which a class is derived from derived class. Okay, this is called derived class, and this is called derived class, and this is called derived class. Okay, so derivation of a class from another derived class is called multi level inheritance. Okay, I am deriving a class from another derived class is called multiple inheritance. A new class is derived from the base class serves as the base for further inheritance. Okay. ఆల్రెడీ ఒక క్లాస్ అనేది క్రియేట్ చేశాను బి అనేది, విచ్ విల్ బి యాక్టింగ్ యాజ్ ఎ బేస్ క్లాస్ ఫర్ అనదర్ క్లాస్, దెన్ ఐ కెన్ సే ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మల్టీ లెవెల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ ది సెకండ్ డెరివేషన్ ద మెంబర్స్ ఇన్హెరిటెడ్ యాజ్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ ఆర్ పబ్లిక్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఫస్ట్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ కెన్ బి విజిబుల్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సెకండ్ డెరివేటివ్ క్లాస్. ఓకే, సో ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ మల్టీ లెవెల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి లెవెల్ బై లెవెల్. సో ఫస్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ వన్ క్లాస్ ఏ, ఇఫ్ ద క్లాస్ ఈస్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ అనదర్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్. ఓకే, so B is a class which is derived, and already this up to this one we have single inheritance. This is single inheritance or simple inheritance in which a class is derived from another base class, only one base class. And if a class is derived from another derived class, because B is a derived class, the derived class lo nunchi nenu inkoka derive chestunna, C anedi derived class, from this I have one more level, like D is a class which is derived from this C, then I can say this type of inheritance is called multi level inheritance, levels. Okay, so this is your class base, and from this class base we have this derived one, and which is deriving from this base class, and we have derived two which is deriving from this derived one. So then I can say it is a what is this type of inheritance? That is called multi level. So I can write like class A, and after this class A I am deriving this class B. Class B I am deriving publicly from A, so this is your next class. And we have class C which is derived privately from this B, privately from this B, and I have another class D which is deriving protectedly from this C. Okay, this is called level by level, that is called multi level inheritance. Got it? Yeah, so these diagrams are important. If you remember these diagrams, and you can write the definition easily or syntax easily. Okay, what is the multi level inheritance is, if the class is derived from another derived class, then I can say it is a multi level inheritance. So what is the syntax for this one? You can write like this. And the next one is your hierarchical inheritance. It is exactly opposite to the multiple inheritance. What is multiple inheritance? deriving a class from two or more base classes. So B is a class which is derived from two or more base classes. Deriving a class from two or more base classes is called multiple inheritance. But hierarchical inheritance ante hierarchy ante same manam parent child relationship anadu. Ippudu manaku oka grandparent unnaru. Grandparents nunchi naku I have two parents. So parent 1, next parent 2 and parent 3. Three parents are derived. This is your grandparent. From this grandparent I have this parent. From this parent also he has only one child, and he has two children, and he has only one child, and he has two children. So this is called hierarchical inheritance. Deriving a class from only deriving two or more classes from a single base class. Ikkada multiple inheritance ante enti? Deriving a class from two or more base classes annapudu that is called multiple inheritance. But deriving two or more classes from a single base class, that is called hierarchical inheritance. And further hierarchy untundi deetlo nunchi manaki 2 3 parents will be coming from the grandparent. From this parent I can have two childs, okay, like this. Deriving two or more classes from a single parent class or single base class is called what? Hierarchical inheritance. And hierarchy anedi ila follow avutune untundi. So when multiple child classes inherits their properties from a single base class, then that is called hierarchical inheritance. Got it? When multiple child classes inherits are derived from a single base class, then I can say it is a hierarchical inheritance. Animal is the base class from which dog, cat, cow can be derived, and the new class can be base for the other class. So this is your class base, and derived one which is derived from the base class only, and derived two which is also derived from the base class, and in the same manner derived n which is also derived from the base class. Got it? All of you got it right? Hierarchical inheritance. Yes, yeah, this is called hierarchical inheritance. So like we are having this class A, I am deriving to, actually this direction is wrong. You have to specify the direction and the upward direction only whenever there is inheritance. So in some textbooks they may define in this manner, but better you can define this in the upward direction so that I can easily remember that B is a class which is derived from A. So deriving two or more base class, two or more classes from a single base class is called what type of inheritance? Hierarchical inheritance. The hierarchy anedi further ga divide avochu. There is a class called employee from which we are deriving three more classes called manager class, secretary and teacher. So manager employee anedi manager avochu, secretary avochu, teacher avochu. So there is a class called employee, and manager is a class which is derived from the employee class, same base class. Secretary which is derived from employee, teacher which is derived from employee. So that is called hierarchical inheritance. And the next one is hybrid. Hybrid ante, can anyone guess what is hybrid inheritance? Hybrid plants ante entidi, that is nothing but two or more plants you will combine. So in the same manner hybrid inheritance ante, it is a type of inheritance which is used to combine more than two forms of inheritance. Any combination of two or more types of inheritance is called hybrid inheritance. Okay, hybrid ante it is a combination of two or more types of inheritances. If you are taking this one, if you are taking this example, then I can say this, actually this direction should be in this manner. I can say this is a combination of two types of inheritance. What are those? Can anyone tell?
Single
కూడా ఉంది దీంట్లో. ఓకే, వి హావ్ త్రీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. యాక్చువల్లీ త్రీ టైప్స్ అనుకోవచ్చు, లేదా ఫోర్ టైప్స్ అని కూడా అనుకోవచ్చు. ఇక్కడ క్లాస్ డి ఉంది విచ్ ఈస్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఓన్లీ క్లాస్ బి, దెన్ ఐ కెన్ సే ఇట్ ఈస్ అ సింగిల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. అండ్ క్లాస్ డి విచ్ ఈస్ డిరైవింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ త్రీ క్లాసెస్, దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్?
మల్టిపుల్
ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. ఓకే, మల్టిపుల్. అండ్ క్లాస్ ఈఎఫ్ జి విచ్ ఆర్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎ సింగిల్ బేస్ క్లాస్, దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్?
Hierarchical.
Okay, hierarchical. Very good. Okay, hierarchical inheritance. So this is the combination of two types of inheritance. Or actually, I can have more than, because class D, which is derived from only one base class, and unputte, then I can say it is a single inheritance. And class F, which is derived from D, and D is derived from B. This one I can say it is a multiple, multi-level. Okay, level only. But general ga aithe ikkada class D, which is deriving from three classes, so I can say it is a multiple inheritance. And class E, F, G, which are derived from this class D, I can say it is a hierarchical inheritance. So it is a combination of multiple inheritance and hierarchical inheritance.
if you are taking this program, this example, then student is a class which is derived from this person. So what is this inheritance? Single or simple inheritance? Because I am deriving a class only from one base class, then I can say it is a single inheritance or simple inheritance. And result is a class which is derived from student, and student is deriving from this person. So what type of disinheritance entity?
Multi-level.
Multi-level, very good. Okay, this is multi-level. So two levels only. That is nothing but student is a class which is derived from person, and result is a class which is derived from student. So I can say a class is derived from another derived class, then I can say it is a multi-level inheritance. And result is a class which is derived from student and exam. So what is this type of inheritance?
Multiple.
Yeah.
Multiple.
Multiple. Okay. So this is called multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance because deriving a class from two or more base classes, minimum two unna gaane, that is called multiple inheritance. Deriving a class from two or more base classes is called multiple inheritance. So this entire example is a combination of three types of inheritance, that is single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, and multiple inheritance. So that's why I can say it is a hybrid inheritance. So hybrid inheritance is nothing but it is a combination of two or more types of inheritance is called hybrid inheritance. And the last type of inheritance, that is called multipath inheritance, which is nothing but it is a combination of both multiple inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. It is a combination of multiple inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. Actually, it is also subcategory of what hybrid inheritance would be. Hierarchical inheritance. It is also a subtype of hybrid inheritance only. But what is this multipath inheritance is? It is exactly a combination of multiple inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. So what is the definition? You have to remember this diagram so that you can easily remember. So yeah, ikkada ikkada nunchi ikkada varaku a type of inheritance cheppandi. Ikkada nunchi ikkada
hierarchy.
Hierarchy. Okay, very good. Hierarchy, because deriving two or more child classes from a single base class is called hierarchy. And ikkada nunchi ikkadiki a type of inheritance cheppandi.
Multiple.
Multiple, very good. Okay, because D is a class which is derived from B and C. Okay, deriving a class from two or more base classes is called multiple inheritance. Deriving two or more child classes from a single base class is called hierarchical inheritance. So deenni manam oka vela ila it is a combination of both hierarchical and multiple inheritance. Okay, multipath inheritance is a subcategory of hybrid inheritance only. Multipath inheritance is a subcategory of hybrid inheritance only. Endukante in the coming classes in .NET and .NET gaani java lo gaani veetlalo multipath ani separate ga undadu adi hybrid inheritance lone one of the part annadu. So but in case of C++ language we have this multipath inheritance separately, in which it is a combination of both hierarchical and multiple inheritance, in which deriving a class from two or more classes which are derived from the same base class, that concept is called multipath inheritance. ఈ డయాగ్రామ్ ఉంటే మీకు ఈజీగా అర్థమవుతుంది. డిరైవేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఏ క్లాస్ ఫ్రమ్ అదర్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాసెస్, డిరైవింగ్ ఏ క్లాస్ ఫ్రమ్ టూ ఆర్ మోర్ బేస్ క్లాసెస్ విచ్ ఆర్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సేమ్ బేస్ క్లాస్. డిరైవింగ్ ఏ క్లాస్ ఫ్రమ్ టూ ఆర్ మోర్ బేస్ క్లాసెస్ విచ్ ఆర్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సేమ్ బేస్ క్లాస్ దెన్ దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మల్టీపాత్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. ఇట్ ఇన్వాల్వ్స్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద త్రీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ మల్టీ లెవెల్ అండ్ హైరార్కల్. Multiple. It is a combination of multiple and hierarchical. Multi-level and good indicator nachante ikkada levels unnai gaati. D is A and A D to B and B to A. So levels kuda unnai gaati, multi-level kuda. So I can say it is a combination of three types of inheritance. That is your multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, and multi-level. Because I have these levels kaabatti multi-level kuda. I can say multi-level. So multipath inheritance is a combination of three types of inheritance: multiple inheritance, multi-level, and hierarchical inheritance. It has one famous problem called diamond problem antaru, endukante itla diamond shape lo vachindi kabatti diamond problem antaru. We will discuss about this diamond problem in the coming classes. Our diamond problem ni rectify cheyadaniki common ga edaithe base class undo deenni virtual chestaru, that is called virtual base class. We will discuss that in the coming classes. So multipath inheritance is this one. Okay, so yeah, here class D is derived from the base classes B and C directly from the A. Okay, so all of you got it right?
Yes sir.
Yeah, so what are these different types of inheritances? We have discussed this single inheritance. single inheritance in which if we are deriving a class from only one base class, then this is called single inheritance or simple inheritance. If you are deriving a class from two or more base classes in this manner, then I can say it is what type of inheritance? What is this type of inheritance?
Yeah, multiple
inheritance. And deriving a class from another derived class, is called what type of inheritance? This one.
Multi-level.
And deriving two or more classes from a single base class, then what is this type of inheritance? Deriving a class from two or more classes from a single base class, then what is this type of
hierarchical?
మీరు ఫర్దర్ గా ఇంకా నెక్స్ట్ లెవెల్ కూడా ఉండొచ్చు. హైరార్కల్ అనగానే మీరు పేరెంట్ చైల్డ్ రిలేషన్షిప్ గుర్తుంచుకోండి. గ్రాండ్ పేరెంట్ నుంచి 3 పేరెంట్స్ వచ్చాయి, పేరెంట్ నుంచి మళ్ళీ చైల్డ్స్ వస్తాయి, చైల్డ్స్ నుంచి సబ్ చైల్డ్స్, అలా మనకి హైరార్కల్ గా ఉంటుంది. దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ హైరార్కల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. బట్ జనరల్ గా మనము ఓన్లీ డిరైవింగ్ టూ ఆర్ మోర్ క్లాసెస్ ఫ్రమ్ ఏ సింగిల్ బేస్ క్లాస్ అనేది డెఫినేషన్ లాగా తీసుకుంటాము, అండ్ డిరైవింగ్ ఏ క్లాస్ ఫ్రమ్ టూ ఆర్ మోర్ బేస్ క్లాసెస్. దీన్ని ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ఈ డయాగ్రామ్ ని రివర్స్ చేస్తే దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మల్టిపుల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, ఆర్ మల్టిపుల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ ని ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ రివర్స్ చేస్తే దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ హైరార్కల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. And the next one is hybrid inheritance, which is a combination of two or more types of inheritances. Like this one. This is a combination of single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, and multiple inheritance. So hybrid inheritance is a combination of two or more types of inheritances. And what is the next one? Last one is your multi-path inheritance. Multi-path inheritance is a combination of hierarchical inheritance, multi-path inheritance, and multi-level inheritance. So okay, always you have to draw the diagram like A, B, C, and D. Always better to write in the diamond only. So you can say like this. In this manner you can draw in this manner, or otherwise you can draw directly to make this as diamond shape. So B and C are classes which are derived from the same base class, and D is a class which is derived from this one. Okay. So deriving a class from two or more base classes which are derived from the same base class, then this is called multipath inheritance. And the problem that is there in the multipath inheritance is called diamond problem. So it is in the diamond shape, that's why I can say it is a diamond problem. So this is your single inheritance, and this is your multiple inheritance, and this is your multi-level inheritance, and this is your hierarchical inheritance, this is your hybrid, and one of the subcategory of hybrid is your multipath inheritance. So hybrid inheritance is, it is a combination of more than one type of inheritance is called hybrid inheritance. Multipath inheritance is a combination of hierarchical inheritance, multipath inheritance, and multi-level inheritance. Hope everyone is clear, right?
Yes, sir.
So now I'm explaining about the example programs on this public derivation and private derivation. Okay. In the coming tomorrow's class, we will see about this different types of inheritances with example programs. So that is, we have seen already what are the different types of inheritance. And each example on the particular in type of inheritance we will see in the coming classes. Next, this is your base class. Inside this one we have this private, because I didn't mention anything, so private by default. Public section lo set x ane method undi, and which is used to initialize the x value to n, and show x, which is used to display that particular value. And public derivation ante nothing but class derived, and I am specifying this as public. So whenever I mention it as public, then what will happen? Whenever I mention it as public, then what are the data members that will be coming into this derived class? Can anyone tell?
Public
and protected. Public lo unnai deentlo kosthe deentlo public lo kosthe, protected lo unnai deentlo protected lo kosthe ante. So ikkada naaku it has its own private data called int y, and in the public section we have a method set y. So set y, which is used to set the value. And after this set y, I have one more method called show y. So it in the public section of this base class will have x, and set x method, which is used to set the value of x, and it is used to show the value of x. And derived class, which is deriving this public base. So how to specify? First you have to write the name of the derived class, and is colon, single colon, and what is the access specifier, and what is the name of the base class. And if I mention the access specifier as public, then I can say it is a public type of derivation. If it is private, I can say it is a private type of derivation. And if I specify it as protected, then I can say it is a protected type of derivation. So base class and mention chesanu, it has its own private data, it has its own public data. So eppudaithe nenu public derivation cheppano, పబ్లిక్ లో ఉన్నటువంటి సెట్ ఎక్స్ షో ఎక్స్ రెండు కూడా ఎక్కడికి వస్తాయి ఈ పబ్లిక్ సెక్షన్ లోకి వస్తాయి ఇక్కడికి బై డిఫాల్ట్ గా ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఈ రెండు కూడా ఇక్కడికి వచ్చేస్తాయి దాని తర్వాత ఐఎమ్ క్రియేటింగ్ ది ఆబ్జెక్ట్ డైరెక్ట్లీ ఫర్ దిస్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ నో నీడ్ టు క్రియేట్ దిస్ బేస్ క్లాస్ బికాస్ దిస్ పబ్లిక్ డేటా ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో అవి రెండు కూడా నాకు ఎక్కడికి వస్తాయి డిరైవ్డ్ లోకి వస్తాయి కాబట్టి డైరెక్ట్లీ ఐ కెన్ క్రియేట్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఫర్ దిస్ డిరైవ్డ్ క్లాస్ అండ్ ఐ కెన్ కాల్ దిస్ సెట్ ఎక్స్ మెథడ్ సెట్ ఎక్స్ ఎక్కడ ఉంది యాక్చువల్ గా set y show x show so this is a simple program so now I will try to compile this program if the compilation is successful then I will try to run this program that's it okay so by using this program I think I have this small errors I'll try to compile Once you compile this program, then I will try to run this. So this program just it will display the 10-20 values. That's it. Okay, because I am having, but only the concept you have to understand is as I am deriving this base class publicly. Whatever the public data members that are there inside this base class, those will be coming into the derived class, so that I can directly create the object for this derived class and I can access those setX and showX method. But setX and showX methods are the base class methods. So this is your public derivation, and now we will see about this private derivation. So in case of this private derivation, so we have this same thing. Intex is there, and public section we have the setX method and showX method. Public section don't have it. But only thing is derived class. I am deriving privately. Okay, I am deriving privately. Just I change the syntax to private private only. So what is the what will happen whenever you derive privately? Then what will happen? Yeah. In case of this private derivation, what will happen? Yeah.
Public will come into private.
Yeah. Whatever the data members that are there inside this base class, both in the public section and protected section, those will become what?
Private.
Private data in the derived class. So ikkada meeku by default ga meeku ikkada em avutundante. So what will going to happen over here is so here ee private section ikkada nenu em rayaledu kabatti idi private section ee private section loki em em ostayi direct ga naaku ikkada setx ane method ee private section loki vastundi next showx anedi kuda ekkadiki vastundi private section loki vastundi ante kada
yes sir
okay yes, sir. Because yeah as I am deriving privately so whatever the public data members and protected members that are there in the base class those will become private data members in the derived class so derived section lo ikkada em define cheyaledante private so ee private section lo setx setx next showx ee rendu kuda private section lo vachestayi so ippudu nenu public lo ivi unnai so now I am creating the object and I am accessing setx and showx then what will be the result of this program can anyone tell what will be the result of this program
error
okay what is that error
private members cannot be accessed
yeah, very good private members cannot be accessed outside the class because setx is a private member function in the derived and showx is also become private only so I am trying to access this setx and showx from outside the class so that's why it will give error now private to the derived class okay I will try to compile this program yeah what is that error this is base setx which is inaccessible okay base setx which is inaccessible and base showx which is inaccessible because these both setx and showx both are private public aina gaane as I am deriving privately then whatever the public data members that are there in the base class those will be become in the private variables in the derived class So these private data members I cannot access outside the class. Understand, right? Today's class.
Yes, sir.
Okay then. Thank you. Thank you all.